my name is Dr. Viril Admitide, and today I will tell you about novel technologies which you can apply for student training. The outline of the talk, adaptation of boarding PowerPoint presentations for online education, introduction of virtual laboratory work such as aspirin synthesis, titration experiments, optical and confocal microscopy, and also a few tips of evaluation of students' individual work using TestPad and other softwares. The pandemic COVID-19 forced teachers to adapt educational methods of teaching to remote mode. Fortunately, a great number of online courses for enhancement of teaching skills for teachers have been present in internet and in most cases free of charge. Peoples of all ages and different specialties now have an opportunity to study remotely. Nowadays, distance learning is supposed to be effective for almost any person, regardless of current employment, location, field of interest, given opportunity to improve level of education and qualification. Therefore, teaching staff of universities face the necessity to organize the educational process on the basis of up-to-date information and modern communication tools. This is an example of ordinary slide, organic synthesis, and as one can see, it is not bright, it doesn't attract attention. It's worth to note that when students are listening the presentation or lecture, they also can be distracted easily by various smart devices and also by presence of other persons in the room. That's why the presentation should be bright, informative to eye. One way is to represent the same structures in a different way. Explain that with a blue color we point nitrogen, red color represents oxygen, carbon, and white hydrogen. Therefore, when you do this type of illustrations, you attract attention of students, and also you can stimulate them and motivate for self-education using various recorded video lectures. So in the mode of remote learning, teacher cannot spend all his time giving lecture, as it is time consuming and also inefficient, as in the class we have different types of students who has poor ability, for instance, to understand the new topic, and therefore it is quite convenient to record the lecture and upload it to YouTube, and then use online meeting with the students just for discussion of new topic and for doing some individual work with a teacher or teamwork. We have to establish teaching earlier and often, post announcement and appear on video and practice, and participate in discussion. So seminars should be interactive. I usually use Zoom video conference. It can be WebEx, Microsoft Teams. All these options has to communicate with students individually online via chat box. For instance, I give students a question in the chat box, and then they have to reply in the chat box as a private message to me. And therefore, at the same period of time, I can evaluate many students. Also, this document will be saved in a text document, and afterwards it will be properly documented. Presentations should be connected with a real world application. It should motivate students by making or solving real world problems, we have to show students how they will apply this knowledge and what they are learning. Break learning into small parts. As you know, it is well known and proven that you can catch attention of students even in offline mode just for maximum 15 minutes. That's why during the lesson you have to change the format of the lesson, for instance 10 minutes for online communication like verbally, then 15 minute questions and answers via chat box, and then we can repeat again verbal communication. Establish a pattern of activity and also deadline dates. All students should know when they should send their essays. Networking can be done offline between students. They usually do some group works and usually we don't have a problem with this. And also the task of the teacher is to provide technical support information, how they can perform, for instance, virtual laboratory work, or where they can get some information from peer-reviewed journals. And also feedback. Usually when we work with a Moodle system and when we mark, evaluate students' individual work, we should give some short feedback that student knows why he got the score and how he can improve his future work in order to get a higher score. Engage students. The quality of interaction between students is a sign of a successful class. Create educational experiments for students that are challenging in the region and that extend their academic abilities. For instance, as extra task for students who wants to widen his knowledge, I usually offer to perform a task in Cambridge challenge. Then they can use, of course, all online sources, but even though they are studying and developing during performing this interesting task. Brainstorming is also useful when you give students difficult task, and usually it is much more efficient if you give them this task in a chat box and then they reply in a common chat box within the Zoom or WebEx, and then they see other like ideas. Otherwise it cannot be done like verbally. Otherwise, it will be too crowded and you spend your online time inefficiently. And also, it is very important to use virtual laboratory works. For example, in this animation, it is shown a synthesis of aspirin from hydroxybenzoic acid and acetic acid anhydride, which results information of ester group, and byproduct like acetic acid. And also this is quite interactive, visualized, changing the radical, for instance. It shows that not only acetic acid anhydride can be used, but also other compounds like acetic acid chloranhydride, or it shows that other anhydride can be used in order to prepare as a derivative of hydroxybenzoic acid, and also how time affects yield and the combination of different reagents. First step, a short quiz which asks a few questions regarding the video which students was shown previously, and after that next it will give you the correct number of answers. And the next task is to calculate molecular mass of the compound. You need to highlight each carbon atoms, then oxygen atoms and hydrogen atoms. Press next and it will give you the correct answer. And the practical work itself, we place a beaker on the balance, then we level to zero the balance, and after that addition of anhydride of acetic acid. You need to get 18 grams plus minus 2%. For that you need to use a different size of drops. Quite entertaining. Another experiment is to synthesis of aspirin. So we place our hydroxybenzoic acid into the flask with the chloranhydride of acetic acid. Then what you need to do is to adjust level of flame in order to get water boil. You can change direction of water here. It is in the correct way now, and also balance the level of water in the water bath. How to generate crystallization of aspirin after the synthesis? We place some water inside of the solution which contain product of reaction aspirin with acetic acid, and then in order to get crystallization, cool down the solution and also scratch gently with a glass rod, and it generates the formation of crystals. I think that this is a very good approach to attract attention of students to organic synthesis, to pharmacy, and then they will be happy to make some experiments in the lab in offline mode. The task in order to calculate yield of aspirin, and you need to select right answers, what is the limiting reagents, taking into account these two molar quantities, then you calculate the yield. Everything is quite simple. My students could make this experiment within half an hour. They were very satisfied. And also this software allows you to send teachers feedback and get some comments from the teacher in order to get a high score next time. And also this system shows you where you use two attempts or one you made. Another very interesting laboratory work is a titration. It's very useful in pharmacy for quantitative evaluation of substances. This platform allows you to train your skills in acidic titration and also oxidation titration using potassium permanganate. This is simple. You need to select correct answers, and then other short quiz you need to perform before you start the experimental part. And now the experiment with measuring the mass, sodium hydroxide. It's useful that it highlights safety, that glasses and hair are tied back, and you should wear lab coats. Everything is clear. Students' practical skills. How to manipulate with balance. How to get the precise mass of the compound. Another virtual laboratory work related to microscopy, optical microscopy experiment. I give you some list of sources where you can get different type of simulation with a work on optical microscope. For example, if you need to adjust focus or other parameters, you can just scroll with the mouse and you can get a clear picture. With all these trainings, students get a clear understanding how to work with a microscope, at least more or less, that they should start explore the sample from the low magnification and then to go to high magnification. There are a lot of tutorials how to work with a confocal microscope. For example, confocal microscopy is more complicated than that optical microscopy. Of course, before you go to offline training, it's better that students will pass several times through this simulation in order to get familiar with all settings which you need to adjust. There are options to change the spacement to get practical skills of adjustment on different species. Example, how they explore, for instance, kidney of the mouse, how the image will change if you change other parameters. I won't go to details.